Hey guys, so today I decided to try to do a Taylor Lachey makeup look. Taylor Lachey is a model. She's really pretty and I'm really inspired by her look. And I don't know, her makeup is really nice and I think it suits her face and her eye shape. So I don't know how it's gonna look on me, but let's go ahead and give it a try. The best example that I found is actually in black and white, and it's this one. It went on Pinterest. You can see, I've noticed that in her makeup, she has like a smudged out lower lash line, and then her liner is also a little bit smudged out. And she always has this sort of like wash of color on her lid, like the red lip. So that's what I'm gonna try to do. I'm gonna start off with my Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation. And just take the spatula and just wipe some product on. And if you are interested in trying a foundation that is like has a pretty natural finish but still offers decent coverage, I would recommend this foundation because, oh my gosh, I really love it. Oh shoot, I forgot to bring a mirror, so I'm just gonna use this little one. I discovered Taylor Lachey pretty recently, like maybe 2 years ago. And I really love her look. She kind of has that, you know, that look. She kind of was my style inspiration for a while, and I got really excited to see someone else who was greatly inspired by Jane Birkin and Anna Karina and stuff like that. Well, you know, you can clearly tell by the shorts she was in and her makeup and stuff. Those are the type of things that inspire her. Next, I'm just gonna take the concealer that goes with that foundation. It's called the Photo Focus Foundation. And I'm just going to apply that right there. You can even put a little bit right there. I have these little blemishes on top of my lip. Must be from eating fried pork rinds. So I just blend this in with my finger. I was all about that blending sponge for a while, but I don't know how I like it with this foundation and this concealer. I feel like the sponge takes away some of the coverage of the foundation, and to me, I find this foundation to be medium coverage foundation. So I want to keep as much coverage as I can. Alright. That's concealer done. I'm using my e.l.f. powder. This is the shade in Soft Luminance. I take the puff that it comes with and I just sort of use that to apply the powder. Almost like baking. But, you know, it's a generous amount that I put on. But that's because I want it to stay all day. I put the bulk of the product under my eyes, like around my eyes to set it, since that's where my concealer is at. And then what I bring all over my face. You know, they repackaged these and it's pretty cool because it has a little sifter now. And, oh my gosh, it's really convenient. It's way less messy than the last packaging that they had. I hate this brush. To wipe off the excess powder, I just take this MAC 136 brush, and it's really bad because it sheds like crazy everywhere. I just blend that out. There we go. That's my puffy face. Up next, I take this cool little brush. This is the e.l.f. blush brush, and I like how it's nice and tapered. And my Physician's Formula Nude Wear bronzer. And I just take the three colors right here. I ignore this sad gold one. I've never used it, but I don't want it to be, the other colors are matte. Besides this top one, which is just a little bit, it has a sheen, but I don't want glitter on my bronzer. So, and this is all just like my basic everyday makeup. Sorry, look at my forehead. So weird. I have all these baby hairs. I hate my forehead. Okay, I'll stop scaring you with my weird looking forehead. Okay. So that's my bronzer. I really, really like wearing bronzer these days. Just take my big powder brush one more time and I just blend it out. And then for blush, I take this blush by Essence. It's their Satin Touch blush, and then this Eco Tools blush brush. And I just take a generous amount of blush because I love blush. And you know what I noticed in this picture that I have of Taylor? That she doesn't have, it doesn't look like she has too much blush. Well, this picture is also in black and white. But she has really great cheekbones, doesn't she? So done. Okay. By the way, look at this cute little brush that came in the back of this Physicians Formula bronzer. I love this thing. I got it at Marshall's for like $5, which was a steal because I know that bronzer is usually around more than $10. So I got lucky. Okay, so I went ahead and I've done my eyebrows off camera, but I will put on my brow gel. It's just the Essence Make Me Brow. It's only like $3 at the drugstore. Right now for the makeup, I noticed that Taylor Lachey wears like a sheen of color. She has a lot of different colors that she does actually. So I'm going to go with like a taupey color. I'm going to take this color right here. This is like a, this is called Style Essentials. I got it at Marshall's. It's sort of like the Naked 3 palette. If you have the Naked 3 palette, you can totally do that too. Just take a little brush and bring it all the way. She has really round eyes. I think this should be fine. She has like a smoked out eyeliner. So what I'm gonna use is I'm gonna use this shade now. This one right here. I'm just going to take it on my lash line and smoke out some eyeliner in like the shape that suits my eye shape. But her eyes are really round, so I don't think she takes the eyeliner all the way. She does have something on her lower lash line, so I'm gonna take that previous taupey color, this one. And I'm going to run it down my lower lash line.
Sorry, I'm going to bring this closer on the back of my cavity.
What do you think so far? I like it. I really do. Up next, I'm gonna take this eyeliner. This is also by Essence. This is their, what does it say? Long lasting waterproof eye pencil. It has a little smudger on the back. So I'm just gonna take this pencil. Oh, and this is the shade Espresso. Oh. Take the smudger and smudge it out. And now I'm going to take my eyelash curlers and curl my lashes. I have the Essence the False Lashes mascara. I was using the Marc Jacobs one, which is my favorite, but I need to go buy it. Okay, so that's mascara done. My eyes look crazy. I have two options for lipstick, and I'm doing the lipstick because I feel like, I don't know, I just don't think she would wear a liquid lipstick. I feel like it's too dry looking, and her lips look really nice and really luscious. So the first lip option I have is the Tanya Burr Cosmetics lipstick in the shade Big Kiss. Now, I don't really like this color on me. I think it's too much of a cherry red. But we'll go ahead and try it. I hate this color on me. The camera's not really showing the color. It looks more pink on camera. But, you know, I actually don't really mind it. I think this is sort of like that Taylor Mache color. But I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to layer up what I think is my most flattering lipstick on me, and this is a Revlon Matte Balm in the shade Fierce. I'm going to layer that underneath it, and then I'll add Big Kiss, just because I think Big Kiss has that finish that I'm looking for. Here we go. Yay! I like it. That's better. So this is the look finished. Okay, well this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoy it.